Now that was just what the doctor ordered, and Djokovic on his haunches, really having to stretch, but... Oh, vintage Nadal. Completely out of the rally, surely. Djokovic perhaps took it a little easy on the volley, but that was Rafa at his best.
Well, I should know better. After Djokovic hit this volley, I took my eye off the point. I just thought he'd won it. And I think so did he. And so did Federer a few times against Nadal.
So here's the first break point of the match. Missed out. And first blood to Rafael Nadal. And first blood to Rafael Nadal. Perfect. There's the forehand. How he started the match rather like that. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that time Nadal able to unleash Nadal attack. It's out, and he's been broken. He's going to challenge, but Nadal, who is the closest to it, is looking to walk to his chair. He's stopped now. But his first instinct was to go, and Djokovic is joining him, so this is probably out. Indeed it is. It's a double, and Nadal... Yeah, Djokovic guessed right, and then let it fly. Djokovic won the first set on a double fault. Nadal did rather, and Djokovic wins the second set. Yeah. Yes. Oh. He just lapped up the slice. Frightening ferocity. Nadal really sticking it to Djokovic there, but the Serb staying with him. It's getting easier and easier for Novak Djokovic at the moment. Djokovic is cleaning his clock right now. Oh boy. This is the kind of form that he showed towards the end of his match against Leighton Hewitt and David Ferrer in the fourth set against Murray, 2-1.
Oh my goodness, what can you do?
Fantastic rally. Oh, got it right to the line. Rafa. Oh, yes.
Oh, oh my God.
What an amazing rally. And again, Djokovic in position to hit a winner. How on earth did this happen? 5-4. Too good. Again, so calm. He's missed it, and we do have a fifth set here. What a comeback from Rafael Nadal. He looked dead and buried in this match. This match. after nearly 5 hours against Murray.
No!
Stand in and falling backwards, actually jumping backwards.
And again, that rather sickly smile on Djokovic's face. Unbelievable. Oh, too good. Oh, this is out of this world. He's at the very end of his tether, but still trying to find a way to win this incredible match.
To me, 32 strokes.
I'm not sure he can get up. Stay in the match. And most of the applause was for Rafa. Normally in a situation like that, it would be for Djokovic, who has put in a superhuman effort. But Rafa is Rafa. I dare say, for me, he's probably the most loved player of the last 20, 30 years. Federer the most admired, but Rafa the most loved. He's made it. He's a game away from victory. How on earth we've got to this point is almost beyond words. Can he finish it off?
It's almost as if Djokovic is saying, I'm going to beat him from the baseline no matter what.
Thank you.
Not that time. One more. They can hardly look. This for his third Australian Open title. What a man. What men.
Here's the number one. Here's the Australian Open champion 2012 in Serbia, Novak Djokovic.
He was down amongst the dead men. Look at him. 10 minutes shy of 5 hours against Murray. And now 10 minutes short of 6 hours in the final against Nadal. He is the nearest thing to Superman we've ever had.
Well, he's not exactly built like him, but he's got the heart of an absolute Superman and the mind of a genius. To keep